When it comes to sculpting the visual side of your game, one of the most powerful tools at our disposal are shaders. By making our own custom shaders, we can create a bunch of cool effects like water, grass, force fields, and so much more. And Unity's visual shader editor, ShaderGraph, is now available in 2D as well. So in this video, we'll have a look at how to use ShaderGraph to create 2D shaders. In the end, we will have made a cool dissolve effect and hooked it up to our game. That's right, Thanos, we too now have the tools to make everyone disappear. But first, this video is sponsored by Zenva Academy. RPGs continue to be one of the most popular game genres, and you can learn how to create them with Zenva's RPG Academy. It's 100% beginner friendly, and the project-based courses have been reviewed and authorized by Unity themselves. You'll learn the in-demand skills needed to create complete 2D and 3D RPGs, including how to build quest, crafting and battle systems, procedural dungeons, NPCs, enemy AI, custom avatars, and more. You can get this curriculum through Zenva's Unlimited Access Package, which includes 24/7 access to over 200 on-demand courses, new content added monthly, offline access, and certificates of completion. Use the coupon code Brackeys, and the first 100 people will get 50% off on their first month. To get started, simply click the link in the description. Alright, let's get shading! So as you can see, I'm here in Unity, and I have this very simple scene with a few sprites in it, as well as a main camera. The version that I'm using is Unity 2019.3. I recommend using this version or later. Now to use ShaderGraph in 2D, we need to make sure that our project is set up to use the Universal Render Pipeline. To do this, we'll go Window and open up the Package Manager. Here we can search for Universal, let's select the Universal RP or Render Pipeline, and down here we can hit Install. This is going to install everything related to URP, including ShaderGraph, as you can see here. So now that we have the right package, we need to make sure that our project is set up correctly. When I created this project, I clicked the 2D template. Because of that, I have no render pipeline asset in here. This is needed to tell Unity that we want to use URP and that we want to render 2D graphics. So let's create one. We'll hit the plus sign in the project, go rendering, go under URP, and select the pipeline asset. I'll just name it pipeline asset, and there you go. As you can see, this creates two assets. We have the pipeline asset itself, as well as a pipeline asset underscore renderer. And this is the default renderer that our pipeline uses. You can see there's a reference to it right here in the renderer list. And by default, this is a forward renderer. In other words, it's made to display 3D graphics. We're working with 2D here, so let's go ahead and get rid of this. We can simply delete it. And instead, let's go ahead and add, under rendering and URP, a 2D renderer. Let's just call it 2D renderer. Let's select our pipeline asset and drag it onto the renderer list. There we go. Now the only thing that we need to do is apply our pipeline asset to our project. So we'll go edit, project settings, find the graphics tab. And here, as you can see, we have a slot for our asset. So we'll simply drag that in here. And now our project is using URP with a 2D renderer. Awesome, and that's all we need to do for setup. So now we can get started creating our shader. So in our project, let's hit the plus sign, let's go shader, 2D renderer, and here we can choose either a sprite lit graph or a sprite unlit graph. This depends on whether or not you want these sprites to be affected by lighting. In my case, I don't have any lights in here, so I'll just choose unlit. The process is going to be the exact same. I'm going to go ahead and call this shader dissolve, and right away we can double click it to open it in ShaderGraph. But before we get started working on this shader, let's create a material with the shader that we can apply to any objects that we want. So to do that, we'll right click on the shader, we'll go create material, and this is automatically going to create a material with that shader selected. I'm just going to call this dissolve as well. And the cool thing now is that if we want to apply it to an object, let's say our player here, we can simply drag this new material into the material slot. You'll of course notice that immediately our player goes white. The reason for this is, as stated here, the material does not have a main text texture property. So what does that mean? Well, we know that all our graphics in 2D are rendered using sprite renderer components. And the cool thing about these components is that they easily allow us to swap in and out sprites. However, what our material needs is a way to get this sprite so that we can render it properly. So how do we set the material to use the sprite from the sprite renderer? Well, this is actually really simple and we can do this automatically. We simply open up the shader. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and take this window and maximize it so that we can really see what's going on. And over here to the left, we can hit the plus sign in order to create a new property. And we want to create a texture 2D property. We'll call this main text. And here comes the important part. What we need to do here under the reference is write exactly underscore main text for main texture. And now if we use this name, Unity will know that we want this main texture to be whatever sprite is currently in the sprite renderer. It will simply set that up automatically. And so inside of our shader, we can now take this texture here, this main texture, in other words, our current sprite, and we can have this set the color of our object. However, because this is currently a texture, as you can see it says T2 here, we can't just directly assign it into a color field. Instead, we first have to go here through a sample texture 2D node. And this is simply going to convert from a 2D texture into an RGBA channel that we can then put into our color. There we go. So we've now gone ahead and set up this main texture here that is automatically going to be the same as our sprite. We then change that from a texture into a color channel and put that straight into our master node for our sprite. In fact, if we go ahead and just choose a default texture here, such as this one, we can see immediately that that displays. And if we go to a preview here and right click and choose to show this as a quad, well, we can immediately see it working. And if we save this asset and go into Unity, we can see that our player has indeed reappeared. It's just showing the current idle sprite. Awesome. And one of the cool things about this is that it will immediately work if you have animation set up as well. I just have a quick idle animation set on the player that just changes the sprite. And as you can see, that displays appropriately. Of course, our shader is currently really boring. It's just showing a simple texture. So we can go ahead and add stuff to this. We could, for example, go ahead and add in some noise. So if we hit space, we can search for noise. Let's just select the simple noise. And as the name suggests, this generates some noise. We can choose the scale here and zoom in. And we can, of course, add this onto our texture, or we could have it control the alpha of our texture. So if we now take this texture 2D here, and instead of going straight to the color, we'll use the red, green, and blue channel for the colors, and then the alpha channel is going to be controlled by a symbol noise. And we can do this easily using a combine node. So I'm going to go ahead and hit space here, search for combine. And as you can see, this has all the right channels. So we'll go red from our texture, green from our texture, blue from our texture, and we can take the alpha from the symbol noise. Then we can take the result of this into our color. And right away, you can see that the transparency of our texture is now being controlled by this noise here. Of course, we should also use the alpha from our texture. So let's just go ahead and combine these two. So let's drag this out here. Let's take the alpha from our texture and let's just multiply it with the alpha from our symbol noise and have that go into the combine. There we go. This way we get rid of the weird background on our sprite and everything looks good. In fact, if we save this asset now and go into Unity, we can see this working. Now, a really cool node inside of Shader Graph is the step node. What this allows us to do is take our symbol noise here and plug it into a step node and then go from the step node over to our multiply. So we just put a step node in between here. And what this allows us to do is go between 0 and 1 and reveal more and more of our noise. And basically what this step node here is doing is that it's only accepting values that are lower than whatever we input here to go through. So if I set this to something like 0.2, any values that are lower than 0.2 or darker on this image are going to be allowed through as white spots. And they are in turn going to control the alpha of our character. This way we get this really cool organic fade in. In fact, we can go ahead and add a property to control that up here. So let's go ahead and hit the plus sign. Let's add a vector 1 or just a simple float value. Let's call it fade. Let's set the reference here to underscore fade. So if we ever want to control it through a script, this is what we're going to be using. We'll have a look at that later. And we can then take and drag this property in here and hook it up to our input. So now we can set that value over here. We can just set it to 0.4 and there you go. It updates for everything. And even cooler is that if we now save this asset and select our material in Unity, we can see that we can control it inside of the inspector. In fact, we can do this with a nice slider by simply changing the mode to slider and have it go between 0 and 1. So now we can simply slide this value up and down. You'll also notice that this is currently looking a bit weird on our player here. It's kind of distorting on the horizontal axis. And the reason for that is that this sprite here is actually part of a larger sprite sheet. So if I click on the player here and click on the idle, as you can see, there's this whole sprite sheet here, and it's not completely rectangular. So our noise is actually being stretched along the sprite sheet, and that's not something we want. So to fix this inside of Shader Graph, instead of just using the normal UV coordinates of our sprite sheet, we'll go ahead and use world coordinates instead. So if we hit space, we can input position here, and here we can choose a space. We could either choose the world, view, or object. I'm going to choose object so that our noise will follow around our object, but it's still relative to the world and not the UV on our sprite sheet. And right away, if we save this, we can see that the weird stretching indeed goes away. Let's also make it so that we can adjust the scale of our noise inside of the inspector. Let's create a vector 1. Let's call it scale. We'll call the reference underscore scale. And let's just default it to something like 40. Let's click and drag. And let's hook this up to the scale of our noise. And I'm just going to organize this a tiny bit. And now, inside of Unity, we can control the scale of the noise in here. Awesome. Of course, one thing that would be really cool is that as we fade out, we add some kind of glowing border to the dissolve effect itself. And to do this, we can actually once again utilize our step function. Because what we can do is we can actually create another step function that is a bit offset, and then subtract one from the other in order to create a fine line around all the parts that are currently vanishing. If that's a bit hard to understand, that's totally fine. It's much easier to visualize. So let's try and do it in practice. So we'll take the output of our symbol noise here and drag it into yet another step function. And we're still going to be using our fade here to adjust it. However, this time you're going to take the fade and we're then going to subtract a tiny number from it. So let's subtract, let's say 0.1 from our fade and then input it into our step function. And what this does is that it basically offsets the two step functions by 0.1. What we can then do is subtract the two step functions. So we'll take the first one here, drag down and use subtract. We'll then drag in the other one. And as you can see, this gives us these fine edges that we can then apply to our sprite. In fact, let's just go ahead and add them right now. So after we combine everything up here, let's go ahead and go into an add node and we'll simply add this edge here on top. There you go. And let's just take the output of this and put it into our master node. And as you can see, immediately we get these very, very clear edges happening around our fade. And if we just save this now and have a look at it in Unity, we can see that they look really, really cool. But right now we're adding them on top of the entire image. We of course want to take into account the alpha of our character. And to do that, we just need to multiply with the alpha once more. So we'll go from here into a multiply node, go from our lines here into that same multiply node, and then into the add node. And as we can see, that should go ahead and make sure that all this only happens on the character itself. So if we now save this and have a look in Unity, that looks much better. And to change the color of this effect, all we do is simply multiply with the color node. So before we add all this stuff onto our character, we simply go and multiply with some kind of color. I'm just going to set this color to a red just to make it really clear. And then we go from this into the add and then into the finished result. And we can of course make it so that we can customize this color inside of the inspector as well. So let's just right click on it. Let's hit convert to property and it now appears over here under our properties. And here we can change the mode from default to HDR. This will allow us to not only input a color but also an intensity for this color. I'm going to set mine to something like 2. And we can use this together with post-processing to create the illusion that our character is glowing. So let's just go ahead and save this asset here. And inside of Unity right now, it doesn't look like much has changed, but that's just because it's currently glowing, so everything is white. But you can see that we can control the color. And if we just have the intensity somewhere around 2 here, we can go ahead and add a quick post-processing effect called Bloom. Now to use post-processing in URP, we first need to go to our main camera. Then under rendering, we need to make sure that post-processing is set to true here. We can then go to our pipeline asset, go under quality, and here we want to make sure to check HDR as well. Then we'll go to our hierarchy, hit the plus sign, go into volume, and we'll create a global volume, which allows us to adjust settings for our entire scene. Here we can create a new profile where we can add settings, and I'm just going to add an override here under post-processing called bloom. In here, we can go ahead and set the intensity of a bloom to something like 0.3, and right away you can see that our character starts glowing. We can also change the threshold here to 1. This will make sure that only colors where we actually adjust the intensity slider here will glow. And you can see just how crazy you can get with this. Again, I'm just going to set this to something like maybe 2. And you can see how cool that looks with the different colors. And of course, since this is a material, we can just go ahead and apply it to any other objects that we'd like. So if we select the chicken here, for example, we can simply drag in the material. And there you go. Our chicken now also fades out using the same slider. And this should work with animations as well. So as you can see, if I play the game and I adjust this slider, we can make a pretty cool Thanos move and make all of them go away at once. Of course, something like this you might want to control through script. Luckily, we can do this like with any other exposed shader property. Here's a simple script that I made that is going to control the dissolving. As you can see, I start by getting a reference to the material from the sprite renderer. Then when we want to change the property, we simply call a function called setFloat. Here we can input the name of the property, we set that to _fade, and the value that we want to set it to. In my case here, I'm setting it to a variable that I made, which will slowly go from 0 to 1 whenever I press the spacebar. As you can see, the variable is here, it starts off at 1. When I press the spacebar, we start dissolving, and while we're dissolving, we're simply going to decrease it until we hit 0. So, really simple stuff. But we can of course go ahead and put this script on the player. And now whenever we play and I hit the spacebar, our player disappears. Yay! That's pretty much it for this video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to subscribe and ring that notification bell so you don't miss the next one. And from here, it's up to you to start using Shader Graph to create your own effects. If you want to learn more about how to create cool effects, such as an outline, or using Shader Graph to create glow, definitely let us know in the comments. Also, don't forget to check out Zenva Academy and their RPG Academy. Simply click the link in the description and use code Brackeys to get started. On that, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Mr. Stark, I don't feel so good. Thanks to all of the awesome Patreon supporters who donated in January, and a special thanks to Lost to Violence Love Forever, CJ69, Faisal Marify, Megan Frasia, Dario Visaggio, Leo Lissette, Jim Shubub Jazz, Daniel Dusanik, Marc-Antoine Girard, Naoki Wasaki, Jacob Sanford, Michael Korobov, Gregory Pierce, The Mighty Zeus, Alison the Fierce, Yidjit, and Erasmus. You guys rock.